Okay, I'll try this again. Now, this is a quick video about buses to the shops. Okay, and all these years driving around in cars, I see the people along the road, and they're walking long distances to a shop, to another shop, or the bus station or the bus stop is very far from the shop. Okay. And they're dropped off, and yet they have to do this walking in extreme weather, extreme heat. Okay, so my big deal today is let's stop this, let's get them out of the abuse cycle of being on major thoroughfares, get them out of the abuse cycle of making people cross those terrible intersections where all these cars are. Let's stop this. Let's change all these bus routes and put the bus routes to stop at where the shops are, where the stores are. Explicitly, do not ever forget the grocery store. That is a major stop. That bus really needs to be renamed. Each route bus needs to be renamed. I'm going to such and such a grocery store. That's really where I'm headed. That's the meat. You want the meat? That's the meat of that bus route, is that grocery store. So every bus goes, oh, this one will go this way, that one will, this one will go that way. Well, we needed to say this one is going to this Danteria store, this one is going to this grocery store, this one is going to that grocery store. Okay, so there you are at home. You don't have to do two or three bus routes. You can just do one bus route to a grocery store. And wouldn't that be great for seniors also? You know, they can just go and they get on that one bus, and then it stops, not out at the curb, way at the intersections. It doesn't leave them out there. No, this bus goes right at the grocery store. It goes through all the speed bumps and it stops. And it lets them out, and then it loads people up. And guess what they're taking? They're going to take their groceries. I mean, how sane is that? To actually leave your house, get on the bus, go to the grocery store, and it drops you off, opens the doors right at the grocery store. Imagine that luxury. I mean, come on. What is wrong with our bus system today? Who is running it? I mean, is this some kind of a weird agenda? Keep those cars on the road, everybody, so we all die? I mean, come on, stop this. We've got to have the buses themselves behave. We need those routes to behave so they help. They help the people, they facilitate. And yes, it does help our oxygen level of this here planet Earth. Okay, so that's really my agenda today, is just that. Buses to the shops, grocery store, directly at the front of the grocery store. And then we get more and more people saying, ha ha ha, I'm not going to take my key car out there today, I'm going to take the bus. And hallelujah for them, you know, more people on the bus, we have cleaner air. Cleaner air means this stupenda that we are reaching of 600 ppm for the year 2100, walking into the unknown, which is what we're doing every day now as it is. We are walking into the unknown, this Miocene history, into this Ogliliocene, Ogliglio, that almost sounds like opera, Ogilio. We are walking into it, we are walking into Jurassic, we are in Triassic, we are walking further and further into this time frame where everything is just so heady that it's just the soot that fills the air, and the soot that fills the air, that fills the acids upon our soils and into the waters, and certain You bet. Certain species just die out. You know, our happy little ape time that we're in right now, that we've been in for the past 10 years, we've been in this Miocene ape era, that even will die out. We will leave the ape era and we will head fully into dinosaur. So we are trying to avoid this, aren't we? We really don't want to test that movie show Land of the Lost. We don't want to test it. It would be a fool who wants to test it. We want to, gosh dang it, we have to maintain living in the ape era. We can't seem to drop back to 280, which is when our painters, our master painters were painting. And Leonardo da Vinci was thinking, was in the land of 280 ppm carbon dioxide level. So we are not there. I'm sorry. We are just evolution of the ape time. Apes are evolving. All right. Now, but our indoors, let's talk briefly. I want to talk about briefly our indoors, because we need to fix our indoors. Our indoor of our car is a very, very dangerous place. The PPMs can go over 2,000. Now, what these PPMs, when they go over, we end up with shorter lifespans. Okay, it's like taking your breath away, literally. You know, for the future, you can survive in that stale building, you can survive in that stale car, you can drive around in it, but later on you get sick and die earlier. So this is what we are trying to stop. We don't want you to be sick and die earlier. I mean, why, you know, what would be the purpose of that? We're all about, you know, let's deal with what we've got here now. So we have the car that is very dangerous. We have our houses are very dangerous. They're so sealed tight. There's no oxygen through, and there's even the current carbon dioxide level that we are outside. We don't even get that displacement. We get a higher, because human beings release. This is another terrible. We release more carbon dioxide than volcanoes. We have so many human beings on this planet that we are releasing more than volcanoes. So, if you look at it that way, maybe we can, start to really restructure this. So we have as many frogs and as many plants that are the plants that we need, because when we start only growing ferns, ferns are not very tasty. Brachiopods. We don't really want to just live in a land of ferns and a certain type of palm tree. You know, we want this lush world that we have now to continue. You know, we don't want to kill off our little tiny hummingbirds and go, oh, and watch what this next thing is evolving. We're not into having the whole world evolve in front of us in a 100-year time span. That is not cool, because we will just have so many die-offs, and human beings themselves will be dying off early. Okay, so here we are, house PPM high. Most people, I think they were saying about an average is 1400 ppm. It's very high. That's house sick. That's a building sick. So I know the Germans, they open up their doors every morning and they bring in that fresh air. Well, that's gets that house sick out. We are these volcanoes inside our own houses, you know. We're now these dinosaurs inside our houses. So whatever's outside, you know, let's say our PPM is at 400. Let's say our PPM rises to 500. When it rises to 500, we can never, ever have our house lower than that number. Our indoors will always be higher. That's just the way it goes. Our cave will always be higher. Okay. We're not supposed to live in our cave, though, all the time. And these machines, this lifestyle, has put us to living indoors most of our lives. So this is all cutting into our longevity. So what we need to do is we need to look into more and more. We have to restructure how we live, the houses that we live, how we can have live structures. We need live buildings. We need to live inside, well, just like the Miocene age, we need to live in those trees. We need to have the trees surrounding us as the walls. We have not been doing this enough. You can build, you can have tree-walled houses, and you can fill them in with regular, what do you call it? Not concrete mountain, with regular soil substrates and straw. You can do that. That's a start. That's already the breathing is coming in through that tree. So if we have tree walls that are alive, then we have to also deal with the roof as well. I mean, all of these things. But right now, our current construction is so tight that we have PPM'd ourselves into danger, into life living danger, that where we are reducing our lives in the future, our lifespan. Okay? So yeah, we need to look into, we have to start making buildings that are really seriously about this carbon dioxide level, keeping it as low as possible. All right, and yeah, fresh air, everybody. Anyway, so we're reaching 420 in May. We can all have a 420 party. We're high. I think that means something in that talk. But yeah, it does. It changes our brain waves, doesn't it? We are breathing. We are living on a different think level. Everything is changing, you know, just by that outside external, that external brain from our industrialization, from the steamboats, from when they started putting that coal they put the coal in the trains, they put them in the steamships. As soon as they started with that coal, then they started with industrialization, wood burning, this, and just as much as they could possibly do, we have just you know, turned into a soot factory, an acidic soot factory. And the very first thing that fails is our oceans. Our oceans do not handle acidity like the land. The plants filter that acidity away a lot better than our poor oceans. Our oceans are the sufferer. That means the life inside our oceans will be the first to die out. So, all right, people. Anyway, back to the buses. Remember, keep those buses going at the shops. You know, that's what we need right now. Route the buses to the shops. So we are not dependent that every household has a vehicle to go grocery shopping.